guys hear me?
Alright.
Yeah. Alright. Right, so Lawrence isn't here. The rest of us has been brought to you. But so I'm just gonna go straight into it. I'm gonna do two to kind of compensate for the fact she's not here. So the first one I wanna do, whenever I do this one, I always like I vow that I tell the story like of it and as I was writing it. So when I was writing this poem, I was writing for an event with the Chosen Movement. And I remember like the day like I was almost finished writing it, I found out that my dad had a stroke. And I guess the kind of stuff I was writing about in the poem made it mean a lot more to me. And a couple of days later, I found out that he had passed away, and this was in like September. So yeah, I just vowed that I'd say the story, not for like pity or people to be like, oh, but just because of, so you can understand how much it means to me whenever I perform it. So I'm just gonna get straight into it. When I say you are, you say cool. You are
cool.
You are
cool.
Okay, but are you chosen? See, conversation about this topic remains unspoken, but it's time for the silence to be broken. Because we all want to change the world. I mean, how many times have you plotted and schemed only to wake up and act like you've forgotten your dream? Picture all that you long to be, but it seems so big, you ask God, does this dream actually belong to me? But maybe that's the wrong question. Maybe the question is, why should it? You see, the other day I passed somebody who was homeless and asked for change, and I completely blanked him. A couple seconds later, I thought, rah. I ain't even opened the same mouth I used to thank him. I didn't even pause. And yeah, I don't know what he was going to use it for, but how can I lack so much remorse? How many times have you and I done the exact same thing? Like the time you said you care and you would volunteer, but you were really bluffing. Or how about the time you saw that girl getting bullied and you chose to do nothing? Or what about the time you saw the guy who was sitting on his own but thought, I'm cool, at least I'm not on my own? Or how about the time you aired that person that needed advice? Oh, that's right, you're muttering too busy in life, but they needed you. All of them needed you. But no, you acted like you couldn't see it. A friend, you acted like you couldn't be it. You acted like you couldn't aid, but they were things that you couldn't change. And I guess sometimes we're afraid. And how can we fix things when we feel so broken? But you have to understand that in those moments, you were chosen. I mean, your dream can be as big as the sky is blue, but how can God trust you with much if you're not faithful with few? Yeah. How can you be expected to fix a nation when you won't even help your friend with a dissertation? Yeah. It's crazy. But in order to evoke God's favor, we have to take care of our closest neighbors. So when I say you are, you say cool. You are.
Cool.
You are.
Cool.
But what does it mean to be chosen? I mean, I never really understood it. Like, why would God call me if I wasn't what he was already looking for? But then I deeped it. It's kind of like when you apply for a job. You see, they call you based on your credentials, but at interviews where they assess your potential. Now, the credentials that qualify us is the grace of Christ. Our potential is shown by what we choose to practice in life. But if life was a CV, God would be our reference. And it's funny because I'm not really a fan of Disney books, but I have read the Bible, and when I read books like Peter, pan out my life, I fly so high, it's like that. You see, he's not a lion king, he ain't a cock, so I can openly say I have Hakuna Matata. I'm not a Dumbo. He wouldn't toy with my story. So let's pray so we can have his buzz and shine his light year after year, conquering fear after fear, so on that day he will repair and we can happily share that we care. and it won't just be a token. We can say that we weren't just called. We were chosen. I hope it's a bit of a vibe. And if you feel like there's closing your eyes and just zoning out and like worshiping or thinking about whatever you want to think about, do so. I don't have a name for this poem. I'm just gonna go into it. It's a little bit mad. How do we stay seated when it comes to things we stand for? How do we end up freestyling the things that we plan for? We wanna fly and soar when it comes to our goals, but ain't it plain to see that our wings have holes? You see, your mind is the aircraft that carries the iron of dreams, and there's plenty. And you take off and clock halfway, that your fuel tank is empty. Your power comes from Him. Power comes from Him. I mean, His word makes it clear. How you trying to reach heaven without the One who lives there? How you want to be icy without the One who flames? How you want the sun to shine on you without the One who reigns? I mean, you can play a game and entertain the idea that you don't need Him, but we're the only ones that are affected. Because without Him, nothing you do will be perfected. But He did more than just work for you. He was hurt for you. How much more hurt is He when you don't see it in yourself? But He's here for you. And you can't do it alone, you see. Being healed and saying you're the cause is like saying you can build a house with no floor. You can use all your strength and you can go to all lengths, but ultimately success lies in the ground strength. And having a great career and saying you're the reason is like saying roses grow in all seasons. Yeah, the rose is full of potential and colour, but ultimately, it's nothing without the summer. But He's here today, so we can close our eyes, worship and praise, and say things like, where would I be without you? Is there anywhere I want to be without you? Know your calm questions, but I'm by no means perfect. I have questions like, how do I measure my value on earth? I mean, it's easy to feel like instead of being a blessing, you're being a curse. But we can't forget that He valued us from before birth. Our worth is priceless. Warranty. Timeless. So it doesn't matter whether you are high or low. To God, you'll still have the same worth. See, £50 is still £50, whether it's in your hands or in the dirt. And He did more than just work for you. Christ, because He stole your wealth and your wealth, so how much more hurt is He when you don't see it in yourself? But He's here for you today, and we can.